check it out. We've all heard location, location, location. That's what determines the value of real estate. And if you're looking for that sweet spot, that perfect location, there are five factors that you need to be aware of. And today, I'm going to show you all five of them.
One shot, now the future is yours. Go! I'm turning dreams into reality. Yeah. It's one shot, now the future is yours. Go!
If we're talking about real estate, what's the big deal with this location, location, location? Like, why is location such an important factor? Look at this. I'm literally on an island right now. It's like a half a mile across. I can literally walk across this island in a matter of minutes. It has 40 overwater bungalows off outside the water, and it also has 40 residents on the island. That's it. There's no more real estate here than that. That's all there actually is to this place. And guess what that does? With this location out here in the Maldives, it means that because the supply and demand of real estate is really limited, guess what happens to the price? It drives it up. So understanding location is actually one of the most important factors when finding the right kind of real estate. So there are five factors to consider when it comes to finding the perfect location on real estate. And the first one is called centrality. Whether you choose to live in a city or town will undoubtedly affect how much you pay for your home. When sprawling cities experience a population exodus, it's the outlying areas that tend to suffer the most severe declines in property values. Like, think about Detroit, Michigan. You realize that there was a time when that was like the automotive hub. And as that was the case, you had all of a sudden people moving there, wanting to get jobs there. It became really, really great location for people to want to live. But then the automotive industry over the years has gone through decline. You've had car companies shut down, and guess what happened? Those jobs being lost meant that there was more houses than there were people. People started leaving that area. And what was left behind was, frankly, a lot of people beating up on houses, not taking care of houses. There was a time in 2010 when I bought over 100 homes in that part of the country, and I was paying an average price of $10,000 a home, when those homes used to be selling for over $100,000. What happened? They lost centrality. It used to be a major hub in that region, and as it went away, it really affected the prices of real estate. Conversely, if you ask yourself, for example, in the United States, where are people moving to? What is the centrality that people are feeling drawn to the most? And guess what? You're going to find prices increase the most in those areas. In fact, take a look at Florida the last decade. I've bought a ton of homes. Every month I bought many homes in that part of the country, Orlando specifically. Why? Because with the Disney-themed parks, it was bringing in literally tens of thousands of employees, while at the same time, it became one of the most desirable hubs for retirement, tea times, people wanting to literally retire and golf, and they had this affordability situation going on where you could buy a beautiful new home for $200,000-$300,000 that maybe in San Diego or New York might be selling for hundreds of thousands more, or even millions of dollars. And so this first factor in understanding the pricing of real estate and how to get your hands on the right real estate is just, first of all, understanding centrality. Where are people desiring to move? And the closer you get to that hub, the more it's going to skyrocket the price. The second factor in determining the right spot for real estate is the neighborhood itself. A great neighborhood will have a few key factors in common: accessibility, appearance, amenities. Look for a neighborhood that is situated near a city's major transit routes and are near good schools, grocery stores, shops, and restaurants. And if you can find those great up-and-coming, even master plan neighborhoods, you're gonna find that the desirability, that the trend of progress, people wanting to move in there, are usually the people that have higher incomes. And as those people move and can afford more housing, guess what happens? Those neighborhoods tend to go up in price nicer than the other ones. Listen, I buy homes almost every single day in some of the hottest markets around the country. And I'm gonna tell you that if I were to, you were to say, wow, Chris, like, do you invest in like the slums and the old neighborhoods or the new ones? I literally am buying in homes that are maybe 10 years old, 20 years old, but often they're brand new builds in these gorgeous brand new master plan neighborhoods. And you better believe I'm looking for the neighborhoods that have the nicest amenities, that have the greatest accessibility to very, very desirable parts of that city. Why? Because those homes are gonna appreciate better. They're gonna appraise stronger. They're gonna perform better. They're gonna have stronger rents. It's gonna attract better tenants. All of those things equal a higher ROI. Speaking of great locations, my wife and I were out yesterday. We rented a private speedboat and we went out to the sandbar because we just thought that'd be such a cool place to explore. Saw stingray and also got to see dolphins. We found some turtles. But along the way, we saw this other island that hadn't been developed. And I asked the boat driver, I said, "Hey, like, what's up with that island?" And he said, it's kind of shallow. The sand is really, really coarse. It's really not that nice. The jungle isn't very developed. You know, the shrubbery is still really low. And I was thinking, wow, when I compare that to this island that I'm on, like, that makes this place look a lot more attractive. Well, in the game of real estate, it's really similar. Like, at its most common sense basic level, you have to ask, like, where is it most desirable? What are the majority of people going to want? And what are the people with more money going to want? All of that's going to lead you to real estate that's going to perform better. The secret is to find a sweet spot, though, where you're not like paying $1 million for a tract of land, or you're not paying $500,000 for a really nice house. You gotta, there's this level where it's like, man, I need that affordability where it has room to mature and grow and make me money. And yet it has all of the qualities where that is its eventual future. 'Cause we're gonna be legends. Gonna get their attention. What we're doing here ain't just scary. It's about to be legendary. Now at the end of this video, I'm gonna share with you the top five areas that I'm personally investing in, because the United States makes up 324 markets. And you know what? They don't all perform equal. In fact, most of them don't perform anywhere near the top five markets. So at the end, that's just a little bonus that I'll give you. First though, I want to address this third criteria in picking the right kind of real estate, and it has to do with development. Development has to do with plans for new schools, hospitals, public transportation, and other civic infrastructure that can dramatically improve property values in that area. Commercial development can also improve property values. So this is what I like to also call the path of progress. One of my very first mentors in real estate said, "Chris, you have to find out in the city that you're investing in where the path of progress is. Where is it going to be developed in coming years?" You could literally sit in on a city council meeting or literally just drop by the city and ask those questions like, where's the money going? Where's the infrastructure headed? And I can tell you right now that if you get in a little bit early in the direction of that path of progress, you can see the prices of real estate sometimes double or triple because of that location, location, location principle.
And bladder voiding, as in real estate, it's location, location, location.
Okay, the fourth criteria is called lot location. And I want you to think about this for a little bit. Where a house is located has a lot to do with what its perceived value is gonna be, ultimately what its real value is gonna be. The second house my wife and I ever bought was on a super busy street. And because of the really busy street, it meant that a lot of people didn't like that house. They were, you know, probably fearful of their kids, wondering, oh my gosh, is like a car gonna drive somebody over? And that meant later it was a little bit harder to resell. And so I got a really good deal on it. I bought it literally $90,000 below what it was worth. So that was actually worthwhile for me. And because of my lease option strategy, I was doing a lease to own. I put big colorful signs in the yard that says rent to own. And it meant that I got a lot of traffic with that busy street. I got a lot of phone calls, and I actually put a family in there pretty quickly that gave me a $3,000 down payment, and my cash flow was $600 a month. However, again, not the most desirable area. It worked because I got a discount. Would I have paid full market price though for a busy house like that? No. I want you to think about, what are the lots that are super desirable for people? Is it the end of a cul-de-sac? Is it in a path of progress, but shrouded away from the freeway so you can't hear all the busy lights and sounds, etc.? That's a really big consideration. Also, if you get a little bit of a bigger lot, guess what that can also mean? You can add value. They're not making any more land. That's it. That lot size, the house might depreciate in value, but the land is a part of what constructs the value on that property. So it's never gonna hurt you to buy a bigger lot than a smaller one in a more attractive location. And finally, the fifth criteria is the house itself. You're probably wondering, geez, Chris, location, location, are we ever gonna get to the house and its structure? Well, I want you to think for a moment about really dated houses that maybe have closed floor plans and a lot of walls and things are really chopped up. And then you got modern or contemporary houses today that have open, spacious floor plans, maybe taller ceilings. They're more desirable. And you know, when you consider location, 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 most of this video has been talking about where is that house gonna be? When it comes to the house itself, just know that your house is gonna perform better if you actually have a really appealing home itself that actually sits on that lot. And those are the five criteria that you should be considering. And now what I wanna do is I wanna let you in on my secret for where I'm actually buying real estate, because check it out. Out of 324 markets, there are only a handful that I want to invest in, because little known secret here is I make twice as much money if I buy a house in one of these markets, just because I have everything going for me. I've got wage growth up, I've got population growth, I've got migration, I've got path of progress. Everything we've talked about is hot in these five specific markets. Check it out. 'Cause we're gonna be legends. Gonna get their attention. What we're doing here ain't just scary. It's about to be legendary. So where are these markets where I am making double profits? But more importantly, what am I doing with those houses and why am I buying them underneath the median? Why is my average purchase price $220,000? And more importantly, why do I actually believe that those homes will make more money, perform better, have higher cash flow, better tax benefits, and greater growth than any other real estate that you could buy anywhere else? Well, check it out. Every year I publish a very, very special magazine called Chrome Consortium. It is my secret to buying real estate in the best markets, and I've decided to make it available to you for free. Like, if you click the link below, I will send you a copy, and all you gotta do is cover the shipping and handling. My team will then afterwards even send you a digital copy so I can immediately deliver for you where those markets are. I'm gonna share with you exactly where I'm buying, how I'm doing it, so you can copy me. And I promise if you do, in the next 5 to 10 years, you're probably gonna make 4 times more money on that real estate than frankly real estate that you could get anywhere else. So click the link below, pick up your copy. My team and I will get it in the mail, we'll give you a digital copy, and we'll reveal exactly how you make the most money in real estate today. All right, all right. You wanna know where I'm buying real estate right now? 1 second. Whoa. So check it out. I thought you might wanna know. So I actually made a video right here revealing my top markets where I am making hands down the most money. You gotta know where these markets are. It doesn't matter if you live out of state, I can show you a path on how you can actually buy this real estate turnkey, totally passive. Click the link, I'll see you there. American Ninja Warrior.